a small expression from the Quran that is an insight to depression and sadness. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Don't feel weak. Don't be weakened. Wahan in Arabic is actually a feeling of not being able to exercise change. In other words, no matter what you do, things aren't changing, things aren't getting better, or your best attempts have failed. And now you feel incapable of succeeding. When that starts settling in, like, oh, my efforts have failed, or I haven't been able to accomplish, then the next phase, wala tahzanu, and then don't be in a state of grief. Sadness kicks in. You become that original paralysis, that original, you know, failure. It then leads you right into huzn. So Allah Azza wa Jalla didn't just say, don't be sad. He actually went to the root cause. The root cause was some kind of failure, some kind of disappointment that kind of wore you down. And it started taking away your own confidence, your own belief that you can actually do better. You know, subhanAllah. So Allah Azza wa Jalla, and he did this, by the way, one of the places he did this is in the Battle of Uhud, where Muslims suffered amazing amount of loss, an incredible amount of loss. But he turned that loss into something positive. He actually, in the very next ayah, says, يَمْسَسْكُمْ قَرْحْ فَقَدْ مَسَّلْ قَوْمَ قَرْحٌ مِثْلُهُ. You know, if you've been injured, then so what? The other side's been injured too. وَتِلْكَ لَيَّامْ نُدَابِلُهَا بَيْنَ النَّاسِ. No, toughen up. These are days that flip between people. You're gonna have easy days, you're gonna have hard days. Don't let this overwhelm you and just, you know, beat yourself up. As a matter of fact, huzn is a state in which a person is actually torturing themselves. The sadness is when you're beating yourself up. A situation beat you up, and now you allowed yourself to get beat up on top of that. Allah says, don't put yourself in that position. وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. You're going to be in the supreme position so long as you're total believers. In other words, these situations, they come and go. But Allah is a constant. You never lost Allah. The one treasure that you don't, you know, once you lose that, you lose everything. And when you have that, nothing else counts. Nothing else is a serious loss. So long as you have that, you are never, ever, ever going to be in a state where you need to be depressed. لا تهينوا ولا تحزنوا. So, so beautiful. May Allah Azza wa Jal make us a people who don't feel overwhelmed when facing failure. And may Allah Azza wa Jal make us a people who can always stay away from, you know, this the shadow, the casting shadow of sadness that can take away all of the good, all of the positive that we have in our lives.
And subhanAllah, walhamdulillah, we are the people of alhamdulillah. What does alhamdulillah mean? It's basically, even though we can talk about it for hours, just a brief explanation, it is two things. Alhamdulillah is two things. One part of it is that you thank Allah. Thanks is for Allah. The second part of it is appreciation. Appreciation, praise is for Allah. Two things, thanks and praise. They're two separate things. Al-madh wa thana on the one hand, ash-shukr on the other hand. They're two different things. Now let's first understand the difference between these two things. You can see a beautiful building and you will praise it, but you will not thank it. You will see an amazing athlete. He plays football. He scored an amazing goal. You will praise the athlete, but you will not thank the athlete. You'll see a beautiful car. You'll praise the car, but you won't thank the car. And sometimes the opposite is the case. There are some people you have to thank, even though you will never praise them. That happens too. Allah Azza wa Jal, for example, describes that the Muslim has to be grateful to his parents no matter what. Even if your parents are mushrik, you have to be grateful to your parents. أَنِشْكُرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيْكَ وَإِنْ جَاهَدَاكَ عَلَىٰ أَن تُشْرِكَ بِمَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٍ. Even if they're struggling against you to do shirk, they want you to leave your iman, and you still have to be grateful to them. You will not praise their shirk, but you will still thank them. So sometimes in life you can have praise without thanks. And sometimes in life you can have thanks without praise. I'll give you another example of thanks without praise so it becomes clear. You have the case of Fir'aun, la'anahullah. He, whether he liked it or not, he raised Musa alayhi salam in his castle. And Musa alayhi salam many years later came back to him. And he actually reminded Musa alayhi salam saying, Alam nurabbika fina walida wa labithta fina min umrika sinin. Didn't you live many years here? Didn't we raise you as a newborn in this house? He's reminding Musa alayhi salam of his favor. And obviously when someone does you a favor, you owe them thanks. So even Musa alayhi salam acknowledges the favor. And he does thank him. He says, وَتِلْكَ نِعْمَةٌ تَمُنُّهَا عَلَيَّ اِعْتَرَفْ. He admitted, yes, that is a favor you did for me. When you admit someone's done you a favor, you're thanking them. He thanked even Fir'aun, even though he will never ever praise him. So you can thank someone without praising them, and you can praise someone without thanking them. When we say Alhamdulillah, then we are saying that we praise Allah for whatever He's doing. Whatever He's doing is awesome, it's great. It couldn't be better, it's perfect. No complaints. And after we praise Him, we are also thanking Him that He did it. There are people sitting outside today. Some of you are, the air conditioning in the hall is not enough for you. Yeah, man, it's so hot. And the first thing that should come in your mind as a Muslim is, Alhamdulillah, it's hot. Alhamdulillah. You know what that means? Thank Allah, it's hot. And I praise Allah, it's hot. It's a different way of thinking. It's not like anybody else. There are other people who believe in God. Believe me, I know. I meet people of all religions. There are other people who believe in God, but what they don't have, the first thing they don't have is Alhamdulillah. And some Muslims, they don't understand Alhamdulillah. So sometimes they're like, man, I don't get paid enough, but whatever, Alhamdulillah. You're not really saying Alhamdulillah. You're complaining, saying Alhamdulillah. Hey, how's it going with your family? Alhamdulillah. That's not Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, from the bottom of your heart, you're grateful. For all the things that are going wrong, you're finding there's so many things that are right. If you're feeling hot, at least you're not feeling sick. There's so many other things that could be wrong with you. You know, if your car has a transmission problem, at least it doesn't have a big engine problem. There are so many other things that are going right. We are people of Alhamdulillah. You know what that means? We're constantly grateful, we're constantly positive. If we understood Alhamdulillah, we would never be depressed. The Muslim cannot be depressed. You'll find today in the Ummah, people complain about the state of the Muslims. We complain about, you know, the ignorance of the Muslims, or the corruption within the Muslims. And we complain and we complain and we complain. I tell you, Allah Azza wa Jal is the one who changes our circumstances. All we need to do is turn to Him and say Alhamdulillah. We have to be positive.